Shalom Israel, this is Brother Elias, and I'm gonna see if I can catch Pastor, see what he's doing. Hey, Pastor.
Yes, sir.
What are you doing?
Some sheetrock mudding. Sheetrock mudding right here today.
Oh, okay. I got a question for you.
Uh-huh.
Which one is more biblically accepted, homosexuality or polygyny?
Elias, you know the answer to that question. You know the answer. All right. What'd you say again? Homosexuality or
which one
polygyny?
Is more biblically? Yes, polygyny or homosexuality?
Oh,
because we see that the state, you know, and the government has chosen homosexuality.
That is true. They have actually said homosexuality is moral and polygyny is immoral. But the truth is, according to the Bible, now I'm going to answer according to what the Bible says and not according to what people's traditional beliefs are. But according to the Bible, polygyny is a biblical Hebrew lifestyle. This forced monogamy is actually, it comes from the society of Rome. It's actually a pagan culture. Point of view and perspective. And of course now it's amazing because all the Christians, we want to find out what they believe. Because most of them don't have the intestinal fortitude to change. Especially when you have controversial subjects like this. Because the truth is, polygyny is a biblically accepted form of life, regulated and instituted into law by God himself. And most people don't want to hear that, because they have grown up here in America in a Greco-Roman society. This whole society is built on paganism. Every bit of it is. And of course, when you start talking about, America and the things that are changing real quick, Obama's getting rejected everywhere he goes because people are in Russia and all these other places. They're not accepting this homosexual agenda like America is. But you know, it's part of biblical prophecy. But the Bible clearly says that homosexuality is a sin. Period. It's a flat out sin. And it's an abomination. And I don't care how many times you try to go and look at it, it's still gonna be the same. Now what's happening today is we've got a lot of people that's trying to mix the church with the state. The state don't care about Yah, don't care about God. And they're going to do everything they can to impose their religious values on them. I dare anybody to go check it out and see where monogamy come from. Monogamy came from Rome, which it was lawful for you to have a wife and a boyfriend. I mean, it's amazing. But forced monogamy is nothing but paganism. That's all it is. And I know that people don't want to hear this. Today, it's neither here nor say. I mean, it's the truth. You can't really do nothing against the truth, only for the truth. But that's just the world we live in. I would suggest that people, you know, they're not going to read the Bible. You know this. And they're not going to believe what the Bible says because tradition means more than truth in these pagans' minds. I mean, after all, we live in a world. How can you expect for the people to accept what is biblically sound concerning marriage and biblical lifestyle when they still believe in Christmas, Easter, and Sunday? These people don't have the spirit of truth in them. But homosexuality is an abomination, period, point blank. I don't care how much the world, how much the government, and how much everybody is getting on board with it and trying to make them all feel good, they still gonna burn in hell. Because the Most High Yah has said it clearly for centuries. And of course, now, don't get me wrong. You want to do that? Have fun. But know this. Know this. After this comes the judgment. But homosexuality is an abomination, Elias. Period, point blank. It's just an abomination. It always has been. It always will be. That's the reason why that, you know, y'all's people need to come out. That's the reason why we need to come out of this world. We need to come out of these church systems and stuff because, you know, churches are a haven for homosexuals and lesbians. Just a haven for it. I mean, pretty much, one third, if not a quarter, maybe a half of the church out there are homosexuals. And it's just their standard operating procedure. And the reason why they do it, because, hey, look what Carlton Pearson and T.D. Jakes and all them say. It's a business. And so when they allow homosexuals into the so-called church, it's a business decision. They're not about to mess up their bottom line. You can forget that. It's a total business decision. But, you know, hey, it is what it is. Believe me, I support people, right? Do what you want. But there's something between secular government and religious government. And I'll leave it with this. Bottom line is that Abraham, the father of faith, was a polygynist. Jacob, of the 12 tribes of Israel, who had his name changed to Israel, was a polygynist. And they were Hebrews and they were Israelites. You got Moses, polygynist. Moses had three wives. Most people don't know that either. But out of the 40-something, there's 40-something people mentioned in the Bible as polygynists. Not only that, even in the New Testament, you know, the people who like getting into 1 Timothy and Titus talking about the bishop must be the husband of one wife. I'm going to go ahead and let the cow out of the bag since I never get anybody to take me up on it. But that word one means meal, meaning in the Greek, and it's translated in other places as first. Meaning that if you're going to be a bishop, you must at least have a first wife before you can have a second or third. So you got to have a first, and you can't divorce the first one and in order to get married to the second one. So the word Mia, M-I-A, is actually a Greek, because if they really truly wanted to say that a bishop must only have one wife, they would have used another word. I think it's hetu or something like that. But I know Mia is the word translated. But anyway, I know I got off into a lot of different subjects, kind of caught me off guard there a little bit, but that's neither here nor say. But anyway, appreciate the question, though, Elias. But hey, homosexuality is an abomination according to the Bible. And polygyny is an accepted form of life, which I tell you what, you better consider it with all these wars going on, with people, when we're losing men to homosexuality and women to lesbians. There's more women on this earth than men anyway, whether they like it or not. American society is polygynous anyway. They're polygamy. They ain't polygamy anyway, because wives got two or three boyfriends, husband got two or three girlfriends, and it's just a mess. But that's what it is. Hey, have a good day, Elias. I got to get on back in here, all right? Shalom.
Shalom.